13 of Super Rugby is kicking off today. Our sport editor, Garen, is joining me in studio. Now, he got 7 out of 7 predictions right last week, so we're going for 100% perfect score again this week, right, Garen?
Morning, Jen. We are indeed. Yes, holding thumbs.
Yes, my fingers are crossed for you. So, 4 games the South African team's playing in, and they're all tomorrow. Why don't you take us through the first game, and we'll go one by one.
Correct. It's a real bumper Saturday of South African rugby. Yeah. So, you know, you can sit on the couch all day if you can. It'll be fantastic. But, you know, the first game is the Lions up against the Highlanders. That kicks off at 9:35 South African time in Dunedin. Not a great place for South African teams historically to go and visit. Very cold. You know, I'm expecting rain and all sorts of other horrible weather. Ironically, the last time the Lions were there in 2011, they actually won. So, you know, that's something to remember. But the Lions team of 2014, if you like, is not a patch on that team. So I'm going with the home team, the Highlanders, to win. They have just returned from South Africa where they played the Sharks and the Stormers. Right. They beat the Sharks and they lost by a single point to the Stormers. So they're really in some good form. They're traveling all the way home. That has to be remembered as well. But this Lions team just not good enough to win, having lost their first game last weekend already in New Zealand. I expect them to go down by as much as 15 points. So two losses from two matches, unfortunately, for the Lions in New Zealand.
Okay. Well, Rob's not here to challenge you. So we're just going to move on. So the second game is directly after that on Saturday.
Correct. That game kicks off at 11:40, and that's the real big game of the weekend, if you like. You've got the Sharks, who are top of the South African Conference and the overall conference. They're playing against the Brumbies, who are top of the Australian Conference. You've got Jake White in charge of the Sharks. He was in charge of the Brumbies last year, so a bit of a, you know, head-to-head there. In Canberra, should be a fantastic game, really one not to be missed. If you have to watch one game this weekend, I reckon that's the game to watch. Interesting changes for the Sharks. You know, they've lost a couple of players, unfortunately. Fred Zellinger, their fly-off, who was a backup fly-off, he's injured, he's gone home. Marcel Coutinho's had a fantastic season at loose forward, he's gone home. So the Sharks team, not as strong as they would like to be, I guess, you know, but having said that, Jake White, a very shrewd tactician. I expect him to come up with some interesting changes and in game plan particular to counteract the Brumbies, who have been really, really good in Australia, particularly this year. I'm going for a Brumbies win, again, the home team, but very, very close. Hopefully I'm wrong on this one, and the Sharks are able to maintain their lead atop the standings from a South African point of view, obviously. Mm-hmm. Brumbies by 3 or 4 points, I reckon, in that game.
All right, now we're coming back to South Africa for the third game. What's your prediction there?
The third game, as you said, back in South Africa now for the next two games. You've got the Cheetahs at home against the Western Force. Now, the Force are also flying high in Australia. They've actually outplayed themselves, if you like, this season. Everyone expected them to be the weakest of the Australian teams, but they're right up there in second spot. Interesting, again, they've got C.S. Irbison at fly-off, who used to play for the Cheetahs. So he's back home, if you like, in Bloemfontein, up against Johan Huisen. So that's definitely the head-to-head battle to watch at number 10. Should be fascinating to see how that pans out. The Cheetahs obviously coming off a fantastic couple of results of late. You know, they weren't great on their tour of Australasia, but they're back at home. They love Bloemfontein. It's not a great place to visit or play in. So pity for the poor Force. You know, they start their tour in South Africa against the Cheetahs. A tough game to predict. You know, I hummed and hawed a little bit about this one, but I'm going for the home side, the Cheetahs, but again, not by many. 5 or 6 points at most for the men from Bloemfontein. I expect a real open running game of rugby if it's dry in Bloemfontein, which would be a fantastic spectacle for rugby. You know, both the Cheetahs in particular haven't got a lot to lose. There's no point in kicking penalties. They might as well go for the tries and win with a bonus point, hopefully, for their slim chances in the South African conference. So Cheetahs by 5 or 6.
Okay, well, I hope you're not humming and hawing come Monday. And now the last game.
Last game, big South African derby. You've got the Bulls at home against the Stormers. You know, normally, you know, the clash of the North versus South, it's, you know, the game not to be missed. But unfortunately, this Stormers team, A, they've had a real poor season to date, and they've lost 6 players since last weekend's victory over the Highlanders, all through injury. You've got Skalkberger leading the team. I expect him to really lead from the front to put in a strong performance for the 80 minutes, but they're missing their regular captain, Jean de Villiers, plus a host of other forwards and backline players. It really is a very weakened team. It's more like a Vodacom Cup standard side, unfortunately. You know, I expect them to be competitive. for at least the first hour. But I think as the game progresses in the last 20 minutes or so, as altitude gets to the newbies in the Stormers team who haven't played Super Rugby at that level before, I expect the altitude to catch up with them. Bulls are going to win, I fear. But from a South African point of view, purely as a neutral, that's probably the best result. You know, we've got the Sharks who look like they're guaranteed a playoff position. We're struggling to get a second team in there. It looks like the Bulls are our only other hope. So from a South African point of view, let's hope that the Bulls do win. I think they will win. I think it's going to be about, again, a 5 to 7 point, that sort of range.
All right, so everyone can share the photos from the games if they attend any games, and they can also tweet us what they're experiencing. Why don't you let everyone know how they can do that?
Right. You know, if you're at the game in either Loftus or in Bloemfontein, please send us your pictures. We'd love to include them in our gallery. And if you're going to tweet, if you've got access to Twitter while you're at the match, please tweet Sport24 News. We'd love to include those next week when we look back at the weekend's matches.